Hey, what's going on, guys? In today's amazing tutorial, we're going to be breaking down Mad Max color grading. I'm going to show you how to achieve day scenes and how to do night scene. Okay, so let's get started. For today's tutorial, I'm going to be using plugin by Time & Pixels, a false color plugin, and this plugin is going to help me to match the original film color grading to the footage that was downloaded from the YouTube from behind the scenes. Okay, so this particular shots, let's see, this particular shots are very highly compressed. Obviously, it's not original Alexa files. I'm dealing with a very highly compressed YouTube file. I mean, really, there is no quality there, but I'm still gonna try to work around it and to achieve the same quality like in the final shot of the movie. Okay, so let's take a look at our false colors. And now here we can see road is very bright, basically the mountains sort of mid-tones, the car and the truck are mid-tones, the sky a little bright. And okay, let's try to replicate that in our shot. Okay, so in order to make our life a little bit easier, let's turn in aspect ratio at 235, just like an original movie. Okay, let's turn it off for now. All right, so in the first note, I'm gonna increase saturation because as we can see in this shot over here in the vector scope, it's very, very highly saturated. So let's try to match that. Okay, and our first note gonna be saturation. I'm not even gonna bother doing noise reduction because it's obviously a highly compressed YouTube clip, so it really doesn't make any sense. Okay, so let's increase RGB, red, green, and blue channels individually to increase saturation. And let's compare our vector scope to the original footage. Okay, very close. We're almost there. That looks pretty good. Okay, let's create another node. And in the second node, let's dial a basic look. Okay, so what we can see? We can see that our red channel obviously dominates and everything else is sort of on an even side. Okay, let's try to replicate that. Let's go to the primary bars, okay? And in order, oops, what am I doing? I'm in the wrong node, in the wrong file. Let's go to the primary bars and we're gonna turn off mixer over here and we're gonna tweak our channel individually, because if you have mixer on, you can see that everything sort of affects other channel when you move individual channel. But if you have mixer off, you can play individually with every channel. I bet you didn't know that, but it's really cool. Okay, so let's see, let's try to match that. As we can see, we have green and blue sort of at about 640. Okay, let's go back and let's try to dial the same. Okay, this one's good. And the blue, let's see, about the same. Let's see about the red color. Red is slightly above 896. Okay, let's replicate that. Okay, look at that. Very close. All right. So we're going to call this basic color. Okay, let's go back. And over here in comparing to this, we look pretty much very even. Let me fix a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna create the parallel and I'm gonna fix slightly more midtones. And by the way, I didn't practice doing anything prior of recording, so bear with me, I'm working as I'm going. Okay, all right, let's dial it down slightly a little bit. Okay, all right, I guess as far as the contrast, we're very close. Our color's a little bit off, so let's go back and let's see what is out there that we need to fix. Okay, let's try to play with the midtones of the blue channel and crank it a little bit down. Okay, as you can see, that's already started looking way better. Okay, because original has a lot of shadows and sort of a little bit on the mid-tone area. So is the green channel. Let's take a look at the green channel. I can probably drop a little bit more green channel as well. Okay, like that looks really, really cool. Okay, and possibly, let me take a look, and possibly we can drop more of the red channel. Okay, let's see. Perfect, we start getting that awesome look. All right, so here we have it. Color looks pretty cool. Okay, so we're pretty good. We're looking pretty good with the basic grading for now. Let's see. Our curve looks beautiful. We're gonna call this contrast. And as we can see here, the car is slightly brighter than what I have in my file over here. So let's fix that. I'm gonna create another parallel node. We're gonna call this car, and obviously the car is going to be all in the shadows, so I'm going to go to the qualifier. Okay, and I'm going to be selecting, oops, wrong way, I'm going to be selecting only the darkest parts of the image. Let's see, I guess like that looks okay. Obviously this is not perfect, but oh well. All right, so let's increase that slightly a little bit. Check it out. Okay, that way it's not too contrasty. All right, looks perfect, looks very close. Okay, we're obviously missing a truck because it haven't been added, but our look as of right now is very, very similar to the original. I can see that the mountains over here look pretty sharp, so I'm sure they use some kind of sharpening technique during the color grading. This footage that I got from the YouTube is not that long enough. I can actually check. Okay, but let's base our grade on this frame. Okay, let's see. Let's check it out. Okay, something like this. I'm gonna grab still and I'm gonna point over here. And let's compare my shot with actual movie. Look at that. They look really, really close. So what we can see actually that the skies are a little bit more teal versus blue that I have right now. And probably I need to increase a little bit more contrast, which I'm going to do right now. But it's very hard to tell because, I mean, YouTube file really doesn't have too much information to work with. So, forgive me for that. Let's call this one Sky. And let's see if I even have enough information to do anything about it. But, let's check it out. So, we're probably going to go to Hue versus Hue. And I'm going to use a picker to pick on the blue channel over here. All right, let me stretch it out a little bit. That way we have nice feathering. And let's see if that is similar. Okay, almost. Okay, let's see. It's like barely has any color. Okay, I think we're gonna keep it somewhere around here, and I'm gonna go to qualifier and I'm gonna select all the blue again. Hopefully it's gonna do the fine job because there's no information. Let's see. Okay, all right, okay, like that looks decent, I guess you can say it. Let's feather it down. And let's go to split screen. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna decrease saturation because the skies over there are very, very barely saturated. Okay, I think like that looks pretty good. And the one little thing that I noticed right now, that in the final movie, and again, I don't know if this is the Blu-ray version or it's a real color, but if you notice the highlights, the very white part of the cloud is actually a little bit pink. So I'm going to show you how to take care of that too in a second. Okay. Well, that obviously looks pretty terrible. Okay, let's find out what's going on here. And why does it look like that? Okay, let's see. Okay, a little bit like this. Let's see, let's play with saturation. Okay, barely. Okay, I think that looks close enough. Okay, let's check it out. So this is my color grading, and this is the color grading from the actual movie. I would say really, really damn close. Okay, look at that. That's pretty much almost identical look. And about the little pink highlights, let me create another parallel node, and I'm gonna call it pink highlights. Okay, and we're gonna go to the qualifier, and I'm only gonna select the brightest part of the image, which is, and again, this is probably a mistake of me doing, because obviously very, very difficult of working in such a highly compressed file. But let's try. I'm gonna create the power mask over here. Let's see, I'm gonna make it wide. Okay. All right, let's, I guess this should work. Let's give it a nice feathering. Okay, for the sake of tutorial, I think that should work. And let's see, let's increase a little bit. I'm gonna turn off the mixer again, and we're gonna increase a little bit of red channel until we're gonna start seeing that little bit pinkish highlight. Okay, I think I did obviously a little bit too much, so we're gonna have to dial it down over here. Let's see. Like that looks cool. Maybe still slightly a little bit too much. Let's see. A little bit too much. So I'm probably gonna use about 130. Barely. Okay, so here's our color grading of the Mad Max look. I'm gonna move the scopes on the side a little bit, that way they're not on my way. And let's add a few more things to increase a little bit of production value. Okay, so as far as our look, we're pretty much there. I mean, it looks almost identical, even though this is a crappy YouTube compression file. Okay, so let's see what else we can do to give it a little bit more value. Okay, as what I can see, it's been really sharpened exclusively probably on the grill. And that is actually looks really good even for the YouTube, but let's create another node, and I'm gonna go to the blur menu, and I'm gonna select sharpen, and I'm gonna increase sharpening just a tiny little bit. Okay, like that looks perfect. Okay, let's see. Before and after. I mean, you can see really, really big difference just by looking at this picture. Okay, and finally, let's see if everything matching exactly 100%. Okay, so this is original. Let's take a look at the waveform. By the way, I didn't even use waveform matching, matching the look. Okay, let's grab still. Let's go to my grading. And let's have a waveform. I mean, what am I saying? Waveform. The false colors. I'm sorry. Being a little crazy. Okay, so this is migrating versus the other one. So I would say very, very close. I mean, it's pretty much identical. Very close color matching. Okay, so let's turn this thing off. And usual, as I like doing, I'm gonna add a little bit of film grain. This movie obviously was shot on 35 millimeters, so let's add some nice 35. And over here you can see before and after to help to blend in. And there we have it. This is our first look. Okay, let's save the project and let's move on.